Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the special episode of the 11th Hour. Sitting next to me right here is somebody this channel could not run without. This is Heather Scott. If you've listened to a couple of my Fallout videos, she's done joint commentary with me. You want to say hi?
I have some of the highest views. And thank
Shut
you
up.
For
nobody
that.
Cares. we're here. We're going to be bringing to you a special episode of this show. We're going to be talking kind of about the video game awards that happened December 3rd. This Thursday? Thursday,
the 3rd? Yes?
Yeah, I think it was the 3rd. Yeah, I think there was the Thursday. Yes. Okay, either way. But yeah, like I said, we'll be bringing you a nice special episode, talking about some of the reveals, the awards, talking about, who got what, blah, 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 all that. Please, stay tuned for this entire thing. Check out anything else that appears on the channel, Let's Plays. This show, the normal show that appears every Friday, will go live on YouTube every Friday at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. Check out this Monday for my special post PSX review. It'll be something sort of like this. What else? Check me out on Facebook. I said Let's Plays. Check me out on Facebook, Twitter, and my website. All that is down in the description below. You can leave me a comment. You can get a hold of me through any of those. Stop making that fucking
You're
face.
You're welcome.
All right, everybody. Okay. Let's just get right into this. Heather, Christ on sale. What was the biggest kind of surprise, or what did you find that was the most interesting about this, about the game awards on Thursday?
I would say that a game that I don't know of won a lot, but I don't know that many games. So
you're talking about Her Story, right?
Yeah.
Just people who aren't inside here. She's giving me that fucking look. She hates me. I have to agree with her. I think Her Story, it won, I think, 2 awards? A lot more than I thought it would. Well, that was only 2. Either way, we'll cover that. I have the entire list of who won pretty much everything. We'll cover that. I found that one fairly interesting. I also have to say, I didn't get what was with all the musical performances. Personally, I was... I don't know. I didn't like it. I would have preferred more about the games and whatnot. Out of that, I thought there were some really cool some reveals. There were some really cool trailers that we saw.
We still have to hunt down Primal's entirety.
Right. If you go to IGN, I'm pretty sure it's everywhere out there on the internet. There's about 30 minutes of Far Cry Primal gameplay. I think what we saw was maybe a minute, maybe. Of some stuff. You can go back, you can check out anything that was shown at the awards or anything like that. But first, how about we start with the three, there were 3 games that didn't make an appearance at the awards, like the actual ceremony.
Are you talking about ones that are like, and also one?
No, these are the ones we found them on, you find them on the website. I think there were 3 that weren't talked about, and that would be the categories for Best Fighting Game, Best Family Game, and Esports Game of the Year. And let's start, Best Fighting Game of the Year, and I believe this is all, it's all voted, all blah, 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 blah. Best Fighting Game of the Year in this competition was Mortal Kombat, would you say 10 or X?
I'll say X.
Yeah, I say X too. X2. Fuck it. I don't know. I in a weird way, I found that one interesting. I don't know a lot about the fighting games that came out this year.
You play more than I do. All right. Mobile version of it was still fun.
I disagree with that.
I didn't play the console version. You played the console version.
No, I thought that was fairly interesting. I thought this was probably one of the most fun Mortal Kombat games I've played in a long time. Go Johnny Cage, especially with that fucking Here's Johnny fatality. Was so cool. Really gross. Stop giving me that freaking look. I can see it. I'm sorry, guys.
It's a force of habit. You say things and
me.
I have to make the face.
Next up, the next category I want to talk about was Best Family Game, with Super Mario Maker taking that win. Is she still... Yeah, neither have I. I don't know. We've been talking about this recently, because there was also something shown. It was these people, they were doing something with PlayStation VR. It's like this weird building game. It's with these kind of games, I don't see the appeal in them. I don't see, there's not a narrative, there's not a world. It's just kind of, maybe it's because I'm not a creative soul, or...
I mean, this is probably part of the same reason you don't like Minecraft.
Fair enough.
but...
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, in a weird way, I really like Rust. I really like that idea, even though I like a strong narrative in those kind of games. Rust, Ark Survival Evolved, I believe it is.
Dinosaur game.
Those seem really interesting to me. It's just I would have liked a more strong narrative, although I say the same thing about those big multiplayer shooters, you know, Rainbow Siege, Star Wars Battlefront, Evolve.
But you don't like those for other reasons.
Yeah, I don't like those just because they're all multiplayer. They don't warrant a $60 purchase. I mean, at least Call of Duty has a campaign, and I will say, I think Black Ops 3 looks pretty interesting. Halo 5, it was shown that Halo 5's campaign was, on the early stages, was played more than the multiplayer. I don't know. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think Mario Maker really, I think, again, it appeals to the younger end of the spectrum and the older end of the spectrum who, you know, grew up with, like, Super Mario and whatnot. I mean, yeah.
I'd play it, but I like those, in your words, dumb party games.
I don't know. I wouldn't say party games are dumb. I think they hold their place. I think that's part of what made the Wii so successful.
Clarification: I like the Lego games.
I don't think those are party games. I just don't like.
Well, no, but they're what you consider dumb little games.
I don't consider them dumb. I say dumb, but oh my god, I wouldn't say dumb. I don't know. Like she said, I liked the first two Star Wars ones, and then. I don't know. I think too many things. It's like everything's a Lego game, and I don't like it. God, are you on drugs?
No, I like Jurassic World.
Holy shit, I like the movie. I don't want to play it as a Lego version. It's like Peter Jackson's King Kong the movie, the game.
I'd play it.
God damn it. All right, I'm going to move on. And esports game of the year was Counter-Strike Global Offensive. I didn't think you'd have any. Hey, I don't know. I don't watch esports, personally. I mean, I always say this whenever I talk about esports. Please, go to the comments and tell me if you like esports. Why do you like esports? I don't get it, personally. I mean, would you...
Please,
I mean,
comment. I'm tired of hearing it.
No, I mean, I find like, the aspect of it, like, really interesting and how big it is. I just can't get into it, personally. And, you know, and along with that comment, I forgot to say this at the beginning. At any time, if you have any, like, anything that you thought should have won something else, blah, 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 please, again, tell me in the comments or find me, you know, on Facebook, Twitter, all that stuff. You know, give us your opinions on any of that. Happy to hear them. I'll maybe talk about them in a later video. And I've also said this a couple times. If you ever want a personal shout-out, a shout-out for an organization, anything like that, please, put that in, find me on Facebook, Twitter, any of that, you know, in the comments of a video, and stop looking at me like that.
I've never heard you say that.
I've said it a couple fucking times, and you've just not been around. Sorry, she's in the background a lot of times when I record, like, videos or whatever. But yeah, seriously, anytime you want a shout-out, and you want an organization to have a shout-out, if you're a musician or part of a band, you want to give me a song, I'll play it at the end of my...
I've heard you say that.
Stop interrupting me, please. I'll be happy to play those at the end of my weekly show. Sorry for kind of like breaking the what we're talking about and kind of going into that.
Do we do a list of events for this?
Oh my god, maybe.
Okay,
we'll talk about that. Okay. We'll talk about that later. Here's something that you might and I don't have all the nominees for this one because this one was kind of said in passing at the awards show. Best mobile game, Lara Croft Go. You probably
played it.
Yeah, but you play more mobile games than I do.
But I don't know what it is. I've never played it. I can look up the other nominees.
Nah. Okay. Well, I mean, I believe one of the nominees actually is the one that I had going for the
Fallout.
Win was Fallout Shelter. I thought Fallout Shelter would pull a win.
Well, I mean, but we have a new Tomb Raider and we have a new Fallout, so.
Yeah, I mean, Fallout Shelter is kind of, I don't know. I will give Lara Croft Go points for, well, maybe not points for originality, because it's a similar game to Hitman Go, where, you know, it's looks like a board game. Interesting little game. I don't know. I believe it's on sale.
Oh, God, it's $5.
Oh, yeah, I believe it's on sale right now.
No,
oh.
It's not.
It was on sale then.
I've never seen it.
All right, what was the first official award? The best the game that was up for the five games that were up for best multiplayer were Black Ops 3, Rocket League, Destiny, The Taken King, Splatoon, and Halo 5. And did I say this is best multiplayer or best shooter?
Multiplayer.
Okay, I said yes. This is best multiplayer. The game that won also won best shooter. So yeah, the Black Ops 3, Rocket League, Destiny, Taken King, Splatoon, and Halo 5. Do you think we should just name the talk about the winner first or go down the?
I don't know.
I'm sorry. I guess we probably should plan this out better. The winner of this category and the winner who was also considered best shooter was Splatoon. A nice Nintendo, kind of not a MOBA game, but you know, a PvP shooter game. Really a childish game, yet in the same time, it's so colorful. It looks really fun. Stop. What are you looking at?
I'm just looking. You're talking.
Fuck. Have you ever seen anything of Splatoon? Heard anything of?
Other than what was it like shown when they named the game? No.
would you play it? I mean, without look. I mean,
I'm not a shooter person. You know that.
Yeah, I don't know. Looked interesting. Again, this is one I've never played myself. I'm not a big Nintendo guy. It looks really interesting. I keep hearing so much about it. You know, I'd suggest go out and check it. I'm gonna run through the list, you know, kind of talk about some of these, you know, more, and talk about, you know, like Black Ops 3, you know,
I've played.
You played Black Ops 3?
Not the actual game, but I've played the series.
I'm serious. I mean, I bet that we'd be pressed to find somebody who hasn't played Call of Duty game, who plays video games regularly.
Challenge accepted. I will find someone.
All right, you heard it here first. Heard it here first, fellas. Everybody, I don't fucking know. Oh God, now she's texting people.
I have someone in mind.
I'm keeping this.
I have someone in mind.
No phones during recording.
Okay, then, like the one that you recorded how many weeks ago that you stole my phone in.
That was pretty funny.
It's not actually unorganized.
She's talking about her phone. She was asleep in my lap at that time. I couldn't move. It was really annoying.
I was not in your lap. I was next to you. The other half of the bed.
Okay, we're gonna stop our squabbling. And finally, we're gonna talk about video games now. Fucking video games. Black Ops 3. Have you seen any gameplay? I've seen the entire campaign. Played through, super psychological, really cool. I do remember them talking about a player from the Seattle Seahawks was going to come in and play a villain. Yeah, I don't remember seeing him anywhere in the game. I will say the guy who played Elliot Stabler in Law and Order SVU was the main bad guy.
SVU.
Watch it; it's a good show. It's on Netflix. We watch Netflix more than anything.
To be fair, we're college students.
Fair enough.
We don't hook up TVs to the cable.
Fair enough. I have four game systems all hooked up to my TV. You know what? Shut up. I'm sorry, my TV doesn't work right anymore. We are not sponsored by Dr. Pepper either. That's not a thing. Stop ordering me around. Okay, I'm sorry. I keep saying we're going to talk about video games. We're arguing here. I'm sorry, everyone. Black Ops 3, a super psychological game. Really interesting. I'd suggest go out and try it out if you haven't. I keep hearing it's apparently the biggest media release of the year, which is...
Didn't they also do the really bad media?
Yeah, they did. Yeah. They did that thing through Twitter where they actually caused panic and they were reporting quarantine zones in Singapore and there's all these, bombings and terrorist attacks when it wasn't a joke, but it was all marketing for this game. I don't know. Go check out. Stop. She's burping in my ear.
I am not.
Gross. Jesus, we're gonna hold off on Rocket League because Rocket League won a couple other things. Destiny the Taken King. I mean, have you heard of this expansion?
About it,
yeah. Yeah. I mean, popping up. I want to say it's NPR. Not NPR.
That's National Public Radio.
NPD. I always forget it. It's, you know, the charts of, you know, like, the weekly games sold. It's like fucking Minecraft. It's up there every week or every month. It's really interesting to see how much, like, this game has kind of, like, held on while all these other multiplayer games have kind of, like, come in and just fallen apart.
Yeah.
And just because of the way this game is, the way it's structured, it's more, it has a little bit of a narrative to it. I think, personally, that's why I'm really interested in Tom Clancy's The Division coming out from Ubisoft, I believe, next March? Don't quote me on that. I believe it's coming out March 2016. Have you seen anything of The Division?
Other than what they showed on the thing, though.
This is dope. Whatever. Okay, finally.
Well, they showed Tom Clancy's Division on the award show.
When?
I don't know. I remember seeing it.
I think she's on drugs. I don't think they did.
I'm sure they did. Yeah, because it's like the time thing. They were going about, you know, where did it all start, and then how did I time travel? And
it was Quantum Break.
I lied.
I'm like, what?
I lied.
It was Quantum Break.
I lied.
Okay. God damn it. The final thing to round up as multiplayer was Halo 5. And not gonna lie, I'm maybe not surprised that this didn't win best multiplayer, because, I mean, Splatoon is super popular. I'm surprised this didn't win best shooter. I mean, because, you know, I mean, we don't get a Halo game every year like we do with Call of Duty. But, I mean, Halo, it's super big right now. You know, they're continuing to launch free DLC with it. 343 is doing a great job. The campaign has some controversy over it. Spoiler alerts. Mostly Locke and not Master Chief. I don't know, it sickens me too.
I've never played the game.
God damn it, Heather, play Galo. I keep telling her, it's a great video game. Stop making that face. Oh, crap. Alright, okay, let's see here. What was up next? We had, you know, a couple games that were kind of just shown, you know, we had trailers. You know, I think for the first one that was let off with was Uncharted 4.
Sure.
Okay. Of the trailer that you saw, what did you think of Uncharted 4?
Well, once we finally got the actual recording where the voices weren't, like, on helium, I think it looks interesting. I mean, I haven't played them, but I watched you play them. I was asleep for most of them, actually.
I hadn't played Uncharted until stop doing she's trying to distract me, everybody. I hadn't played Uncharted until, you know, we kind of came into the new you know, when they came out on the PS4. Mm-hmm. You know, because I you know, last generation I was a 360 adopter. I didn't have a PS3. But, you know, I really love the character. Personally, I'm a bigger fan of that over Tomb Raider. Personally. But no, like I'm super interested to see where this one's gonna go, and also, you know, it still makes me laugh. Was it Troy Baker or Nolan North who went up on stage? I want to say it was Troy Baker.
Yeah, because I think he said Nolan North.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It was Troy Baker, the guy who voices Nate's brother in the upcoming game, and you can actually play that game this upcoming March. I'm sorry, I'm getting my M months. That one's March. Yes, because Mirror's Edge is May. You can play that game this upcoming March. Maybe. That's the problem with saying these things. Like, I'm second guessing myself. I'm going to say March. Could be way off.
Anyway, the quote was...
Yeah, either way, Troy Baker kind of goes up and, you know, he starts saying to anybody who wants to get into voice acting, you know, first step, buy yourself a good microphone. Step two, wait for me and Nolan North to die. No, it was and.
No, because, I mean, if one of them dies, then there's a position.
Yeah, and then the other one will take all of the other person's jobs. He'll have everything. Because, you know, of course, you know, they do everything.
He says, I'm weird.
Yeah, I'm fucking weird. Anyone who's listening to me do commentary knows I'm really weird. Man, we've hit 20 minutes and we've barely scratched the surface here.
Stop inviting me to things.
Christ. We also saw a quick little snippet of and she actually saw this before, you know, like, the title went up. It was Tron Go, or Tron Run.
Tron Run.
Tron Run. I'm so used to Go.
It was computer-y and you didn't think Tron.
No, I thought Tron. I knew it was Tron. I'm not gonna lie. But, you know, she says Tron? But yeah, Tron Run. Apparently it's available now on Steam, I believe I saw. I don't know.
Sure.
Go check that out if you're interested. Always interested to see what's going on with Tron. I don't know. I love the friend, you know, like kind of like the series, the movies, whatnot. Now this one was really funny. They bring out Shaquille O'Neal to announce Shaq Fu. It's coming back, everybody. I think it's funny. It looks like a, you know, I think the original was more like a side scroller, like a fighting game, like a 2D fighting game. This one looks more like a side scrolling beat 'em up. I don't know. I'm super interested to see that just because I don't know.
You're gonna play it, aren't you?
I might. Shaq Fu is fucking hilarious. Let's see here. The next two, you know, we're probably not gonna talk a lot about it just because we don't know much of Jack about this. Esports Team of the Year, Optic Gaming, the new Call of Duty team, not new Call of Duty team, you know, because Call of Duty is a relatively new esport, you know, in leagues and whatnot. But Optic Gaming pulled Esports Team of the Year. I'm not gonna try and say the rest of these just because I don't want to disrespect them and not be able to pronounce them. Esports Player of the Year. You know, we didn't get the other nominees, but it was Kenny S. Shrub. Is that a shrub?
Your hand is in the way. Yes.
Shrub. Congratulations to them. Wish them the best, along with every other team. Anyone out there in esports, best of luck in your future endeavors, future tournaments, all that stuff. Now here's an interesting one. Most anticipated game of the year coming up. It is apparently No Man's Sky coming out, I believe, next summer. It's apparently supposed to have PlayStation VR support. I believe a PlayStation exclusive too. A big game, universe exploratory game in a procedurally generated world.
Well, is this the one that you can go on forever and just never see anything similar?
Yeah.
I don't have anything other than that. Other than I thought Primal was also supposed to be on that nominee list.
Maybe. Either way, that one, No Man's Sky really has me interested. You know, it reminds me a lot of Spore.
The games I've played.
That might be, yeah, okay, yeah, it was my fault she played video games. That is a little bit of a deep cut there. But, super interested to see what's going to happen with that game continuing, especially with the fact that it's going to be apparently a VR game. We've been talking, you know, past couple days, you know, personally, I'm not a huge fan of VR. I don't think it's going to go over well, especially at the price point that PlayStation VR is having, you know, especially with the whole, it's supposed to cost about the same as a new console. I don't know. I'm not expecting PlayStation VR to do well. I'm not expecting Oculus Rift to do terribly well either.
I think it's perfectly fine for it to still be in development, but I don't think it should be coming out as soon as it theoretically will. I think it needs a lot more development before it goes
further.
Also, when you told me that they're doing games that have half and half, that's just poor marketing.
Half and half? Oh, the fact that, like, No Man's Sky is a support, you know, it supports VR, you don't have to play it in VR. I also find it weird that a lot of people are trying to, you know, they're like, we want, like, Until Dawn in VR, which is a really weird game, seeing that Until Dawn, you have to completely re-change the game because the entire part of the narrative is the fact that it's in third person. It's like you're watching a movie. You know, I don't know. Although now there's Until Dawn, Rush of Blood, which is that weird on the rails.
Blood Rush?
Blood Rush? I thought it was Rush of... Either way, that game looks just really dumb. But... That's all I have to say. I don't know. If you're excited about VR, tell us in the comments. Tell us why. All that stuff, and you can get PlayStation, at least PlayStation VR, this upcoming January. let's see here. A new reveal here. We get a lot of reveals from a couple of reveals from Telltale Games. Super interesting. I love the developer. You know, I love the Walking Dead series. I'm still waiting for season 3. What's going to happen with Clementine and all them. They're super popular right now with Tales from the Borderlands, super popular right now with their 6-episode series, Game of Thrones, which I'm surprised you haven't begged me to.
It costs money.
I'm so surprised she hasn't begged. She loves Game of Thrones. Do you want to show your...
I spent money on this.
I don't know why, but she did. I swear she's on drugs or something. But, you know, they're super popular with the Game of Thrones series right now. I think they did the Back to the Future game that came out not too long ago. Jeez, what else has Telltale been doing? Wolf Among Us was really good. I still want season 2 of that game.
I'm surprised you didn't think of that.
Yeah, I know. I own it, too. That's the only one I own. Really, you know, I'm a huge fan of them. I really, you know, and they kind of paved the way for this kind of, like, this episodic, you know, narrative.
Doing a Michonne thing, too.
We'll get to that. Shush.
Like things.
We're going in order of the presentations. Not calm your tits. Boop. Boop. She hates me. Now she's gonna pout. Either way, we got an announcement of Telltale's Batman. Mm-hmm. I'm okay, I'm surprised you're not sitting here going, Batman! If you're wondering, no, I'm not drunk. No.
He's not.
She wishes I was, because it's just how
no.
I am.
No.
No, you wish this how it was.
I do want food.
Well, get it after we record.
I know.
Okay, calm down. What do you think about a Batman game done by Telltale?
There's been so many Batman things between the movie and the games and everything else. I'm wondering what they're going to do with it. Are they going to retell the same stories? Are they telling new stories? What are they doing?
You know, in a weird way, I think trying to retell the, you know, like, retell the origin and all that, I think you kind of run into the problem that Spider-Man's having right now with the Marvel, with the cinematic universe. Everything's a retelling of Spider-Man. I agree that might be a problem. Although, I think if there's a company that could do a video game, like, kind of a more... Because nothing against Rocksteady. I love the Arkham games. I a less action-y Batman game. I think Telltale's the company to do it. Because I think this way, you know, you can focus on, you know, like, your narrative. You know, like, talking with people, the relationships, you know, like, with Alfred and all that. I think.
But my thing is, what story are they going to tell? Maybe not how they tell it, but what are they going to tell? Because there has been so much Batman.
I'm going to put, here's my kind of guess. I'm going to put money on an overarching story, like an overarching, you know, between maybe 5, maybe 6 episodes. I don't know how long this one's going to be, but over the entire thing, it's going to be an entire, like, he's fighting the Joker. But the Joker is orchestrating multiple Batman villains. You know, you have, like, a Riddler, a Penguin one, a, you know, Scarecrow, a this, a that, you know, like, and through each chapter, you're fighting an individual, you know, like... one of his other enemies, and as you're playing through this game, you're slowly figuring out, like, this plan that the Joker has, leading, all culminating to the final episode where you fight the Joker.
But then you're still kind of dealing with, like, the action-y action.
What do you mean?
It's still an action game. You're still going to have to fight people.
Well, yeah, but I mean, you fight people in The Wolf Among Us. I mean...
Yeah.
What I'm saying, this one can really focus on, it can focus on dialogue, it can focus on the characters, it can really focus on the detective work that's really kind of gotten away from the Batman games recently. Yeah. Nothing against Rocksteady. I wish there was a little more of that detective-y kind of stuff in it. So protective of that thing. All right.
I spent $20 on this.
The game that pulled best narrative, and this is what she was talking about earlier today with her story winning for best narrative. That's what?
I was looking at the rest of the things. Your arm was in the way.
Oh my god. Her story pulling best narrative. Anybody out there who knows more about her story than me or her, please tell us again. Comments below, or find me on Facebook, Twitter, description below. I'm gonna try to stop doing that for you guys. But seriously, I don't get what the big deal about this game is. Everything I've heard about it was weird.
I have no idea.
Especially,
I haven't even heard of it until we watched this.
And I say this especially with these other games in this category who also were in the category for best narrative, which were Tales from the Borderlands, which I've been hearing super good things about. Life is Strange, playing it. Still need to finish the last...
Please finish finished the last episode.
I keep meaning to. I keep running it. I'm so busy right now. Super interested in finishing that game. Another game I have to finish, Witcher 3, but still, both of those fantastic
books.
Fantastic narratives. Super good characters. And then Until Dawn, which...
I liked Until Dawn.
I loved
Until
Dawn.
You don't play it again.
I will sometime. I'll probably platinum that one at a later date. But yeah, I really loved Until Dawn. I don't know, like, so many people have been, I kept reading it in reviews. I kept saying, like, the narrative was really, it felt disjunct and really out of place. I mean,
I had to look up the ending before we got to the ending. Mostly because I wasn't sure if I was going to fall asleep before we got to the ending.
Mm. I mean,
it was 7 hours.
Yeah, it was about 7-8 hours, yeah. I mean,
I got done with classes and then we played.
Yeah, I mean, we played through all in one really long sitting. I thought it was a very solid story all the way through. I
sat in a blanket cocoon, like, the entire first half of the game.
Scaredy cat.
Yes!
I thought it did horror really well. It was basically teenage slasher flick, the movie, the game.
With random weird mysticalness.
I liked it. I thought it was a good movie.
Too.
Especially
a good movie.
Very really good son of a bitch. I quit. She owns this channel now. I'm done. But no, you know, it's
just, hey, I'd run it well.
Especially with the what was it? Yeah, there's a lot of stuff that if you watch Supernatural, you'll get a lot of the references. Really interesting.
Season one. You only have to get through season one.
Really, episode two.
Was it episode two?
Yeah, it was like the second freaking episode. Don't say what it is. Anybody who out there who knows what... I'm sorry if I spoiled it for you. Who knows Supernatural?
You didn't say what it was.
Well, yeah, but anyone who knows Supernatural but hasn't played the game
episode
knows what
it one
is.
Was the Lady in White.
Yeah.
Episode two.
Don't say it.
I don't think it was that.
We'll find this out later and we'll argue it.
Because we have to rewatch Supernatural anyway. We're so far behind on the first series.
Not again. I've seen the first season about 9 times.
It's because he keeps starting over.
All right, let's move on. We really got our first look at Far Cry Primal. And ever since that game got went, do you remember what I was talking about when that got announced?
No, I just thought it was wild when we started watching the trailer.
Yeah, that is also interesting, because I believe Wild's also scheduled to come out next year. That's from Wild Sheep Studios. Really interesting game, you know, all shamanistic and whatnot. And really, this kind of looked kind of like that with a different art style. I mean, I knew it was Far Cry because I know what a Far Cry game looks like.
It reminds me of the Vards from Game of Thrones, how you can, like, control things.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah, I don't know. Far Cry... It's a W. I think it's a Warg.
I don't remember.
Yeah. Either way, really interesting kind of looking game. You know, a lot of people are saying that it's going to get delayed. I do know the release date of this one, and it's February 23rd, coming up next year. You know, really excited about that. Actually, also, check out my channel. I will be playing that day one. What?
No.
Stop moving that thing closer to me. But no, the game looks really cool. You know, apparently you can control animals. You know, it showed me controlling a saber-toothed tiger.
And a wolf.
Yeah, some sort of wolf. You also control the bear, and you got to see the bear, like, maul people. I almost said bears. Like, brick for anger. Bears kids about
this. What kind of bear is best?
Black bear. That's a little quote from The Office for you guys. Christ, we're awful.
If you want to get me another Christmas present, I'd take that book.
Oh my god. Either way. But yeah, Far Cry Primal, really interesting looking game. Really excited for it coming out this upcoming February. Keep your eyes out. Keep your eyes out for really any other kind of gameplay from it. Did I say yet? But apparently, I think it's on IGN at least. There's about 30 minutes of gameplay. You know, we haven't really seen much of this game ever since it got announced. But you know, I think this looks good. That's not going to get delayed, but who the hell knows? Either way, and here we go. She's going to have a heyday with this one. We have another Lego game announced. We got...
I should just play the Lego games on your series.
You know what? I'd actually let you, because I hate Lego games. I'll let her play them.
You could start with Jurassic World.
Throw something at you.
I know.
You can do it if you want. I will not be a part of that.
Lego Avengers.
Yeah, that
it's,
we
it's
we,
both movies. It's not. It's just kind of like a compilation.
We've known about this game for a while now. Yes,
you
I
may
have. I've known about this game for a while. I've been trying not to tell her because I knew she'd be bugging me to play it. It stopped looking at me. Either way, you saw what it looked like. You like these games more. I'll let you talk about what you like.
I just find them fun. No!
It's my name.
Welcome to our relationship.
I don't care. Talk about video games. This is sometimes a show about video games.
I mean, it's a Lego game. You go around and collect bricks and build things and have ridiculous achievements. Trophies, whatever they are.
The trophies on PS4.
Well, I played it on Xbox. So...
I don't know. I just still think it looks weird.
I think they're fun.
All right.
He just hates fun, apparently.
Yeah, apparently I do. Okay, let's see here. The final one on this page that I have right now is the Favorite Trending Gamer Award. You know, the people who were up for this award were Total Biscuit, Mark Plyer, PewDiePie, and Christopher Monte Cristo.
Michaels?
I don't know. Sorry if I mispronounce your name. Anybody you out there who see this, I apologize.
And
of course, the one who won, big shocker if you've actually been on Twitter and follow anything gaming, the Favorite Trending Gamer of 2015 is Game Over Greggy, Greg Miller, formerly of IGN, currently of Kinda Funny. Go check out his stuff. Really funny. Yeah, Kinda Funny.
I was still expecting Portillo.
Yeah, she's expecting
I'm super
his
disappointed
dog.
That the dog was not there.
I don't know. I really love Greg. I love Greg Miller on his own. Super knowledgeable about games. You know, like, really a role model to me, you know, for me, in the industry, and especially with what I'm doing, you know, I really respect Greg Miller, especially, and everybody else, Kinda Funny, that, you know, being, Colin Moriarty, Nick Scarpino, Tim Geddes, and, I don't know his last name, but Kevin, their filming guy, poor Kevin, I'm sorry, big shout out to you, Kev, but no, I think the part of the big thing that really gave credit to, you know, like Greg Miller's, you know, his talk was how he accepted the award. He kind of went up instead of talking about himself and thanking everyone. He thanks just some random person who worked on Rise of the Tomb Raider. You know, I believe it was the location design, something like that. Environmental design. Yeah, I can't remember her name. Should have written that one down. But you know, it was a super interesting. I'm just having this thing look right at her. It's really funny. But you know, it was a really nice thing. You know, he kind of giving thanks to all like those I wouldn't say nameless people, but you know, the names of the people, you know, kind of rolling those credits that we don't know who they are. You know, without them, these games that we play, you know, like wouldn't exist. And you know, I think he's spot on.
People don't sit through the credits unless there's an achievement at the end of the credits.
Look at you, Assassin's Creed.
I mean, there's a lot of things you wouldn't realize that go into it.
Yeah, I mean, there's tons of stuff.
There was a dinosaur supervisor for Jurassic Park. All four movies.
Yeah, that was
same person.
It's a movie, not a video.
I know.
All
but
right.
Still, I mean, it's the same concept.
Either way, congratulations to you, Greg Miller. You know, keep it up with Kinda Funny. Sue, really cool stuff coming out of you guys over there. Next, we saw the kind of like the big reveal of Psychonauts 2. Do you know Psychonauts? Okay. Personally, I played a little bit of Psychonauts. I believe it's a platformy kind of adventure game. It was originally on PS2, I believe. It was an Xbox. Can't remember. You know, it'd be interesting to see what's going to come out of that. You know, I know Psychonauts, a really big franchise, crowdfunded through Fig, which is, you know, the first kind of like, it's better than Kickstarter or, not Patreon, what is it? It's Kickstarter or...
GoFundMe?
I don't think games are doing GoFundMe, I think games are doing another one. I can't remember. But, you know, it's actually better than these because this actually lets you, because Fig's actually like investing.
You become stockholders.
Exactly, like you get a share of the profits as opposed to the other, as opposed to, you know, like Kickstarter, where they have no kind of like responsibility to you, the, you know, you people, you know, you just, you give them money. Like, that's what it is. I don't know. I found that fairly interesting. You know, it's kind of interesting. See here, next category was the best independent game or best indie game.
Is that what that means?
What, indie? Yeah. Independent? Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Oh, okay. Well, there you go. You learn something new every day. the people up for this award were Axiom Verge, Her Story, Undertale, Rocket League, and Ori and the Blind Forest.
You spelled Rocket wrong, by the way.
I don't care. I was kind of rushed. And the actually, you know, and the winner of this category, the best independent game, was Rocket League, who also won best sports and racing game. You know, it's really interesting. You know, like, I keep hearing such good things about this game. So much new DLC, new content is coming out for it. I really gotta try it personally. It looks interesting.
I'd rather play Ori.
Yeah, Ori looked really beautiful. I keep hearing how great Ori and the Blind Forest.
It reminds me of that Fox game. The ice and
I can't remember.
Never Alone?
Maybe. I think it was Never Alone. Yeah, the art direction on Ori looks absolutely beautiful. Rocket League, super interesting. I don't know much about Undertale. Same thing with Her Story, except that Her Story somehow came out and won a bunch. Also, I'm actually a little surprised that Axiom Verge didn't win. I remember, although I guess as soon as it came out, it kind of just died out, you know, like, what? It was super popular, especially with the old guys, you know, it was a very Metroidvania type game. If you have any interest in those kind of games, go check out Axiom Verge. Really interesting. The next, we finally got a little bit more of, I don't know, I'd say a look into, it was more of a trailer, for Quantum Break.
I don't want to talk about it.
Quantum Break.
I don't want to talk about it.
Not The Division, holy shit. Quantum Break looks really interesting. Reminds me kind of like, for some reason, like Blanks the Time Cat, or, there was another game. Kind of similar to it, you know. It's like you freeze time and do whatnot. It also, there's like a connection with like a TV show for this. You know, it'll be really interesting to see what's going on with that game. I believe when it releases this April, this upcoming April. You go check that out on your own, because don't necessarily believe me all the time. But yeah, the game looks really interesting. Really interesting. Yeah, third person shooter. I don't know. It'll be fun to play it when it comes out. And now, I would like to give a quick. Moment of silence, you know, real quick, for Satoru Iwata, the late president of Nintendo. You know, they had a big, kind of a big presentation for him. You know, I mean, I said big presentation. It was like an eight slide slideshow, a moment of silence. You know, some really nice words spoken, but you know, just quick moment of silence. You know, for Satoru Iwata, the great stuff that he did for this industry. And stop looking at me like that.
I'm not looking at you like anything.
But, you know, for everything he did for the industry, thank you, Satoru, wherever you are. You know, you've not been forgotten. And Kimishima, you look really scary. Way to ruin a moment of silence, Heather. All right.
Say anything!
You were giving me a look. I'm serious, though. Kimishima, the current CEO of Nintendo, frightening every freaking picture. I don't know if he smiles. Or maybe they're just using the same picture. I'm sorry, Kimishima. I mean, no offense. You're doing great work with Nintendo currently. Really interested to see what's going to happen with the NX. Please, nobody sue me. Stop that. Let's see here. It was really nice to see Life is Strange actually did pull win in some category. They won Games for Impact. Which is, you know, it's, you know, games that, you know, I really don't understand what Games for Impact is. But, you know.
Games for Change.
Is Game for Change? I thought it was
Game for Change.
Okay. What was that? But, you know.
I said online.
Huh. I thought I said Impact. Either way. Life is Strange. Really cool game if you haven't played it. It's very similar to the Telltale, you know, 5-episode, you know, kind of game. All based on choice and whatnot. Butterfly effect kind of thing, you know. It has some time travel, has some really interesting elements that I'm still want to see how all of it's going to tie together in episode 5, but you know, go check it out. Really cool. Also winning Best Fan Creation, not Life is Strange, but one Best Fan Creation was Portal Stories, Mel. Don't know much about this, you know, other than that Portal is still super popular.
Oh, is it part of the Portal series?
Fan Creation. Set in, I'm guessing, the Portals. The Portal universe.
Okay.
Yeah.
Jeff, you would like that.
And here we go. Super excited for this one. Developer of the Year, CD Projekt Red.
Give me the dog.
Developer of the Year, CD Projekt Red. Super happy to see this one come out. You know, those guys from Poland, super good developers. You know, making it. Weirdly enough, you know, we know them as like such a really big, really awesome company. Yet all they made was The Witcher. I think the only notable stuff that we know that they've made has been The Witcher franchise. Stop giving me a look.
I'm not giving you a look.
Holy shit. The other people who were up for Developer of the Year were Bethesda, Kojima Productions, From Software, and Nintendo. Pretty much everybody who was up. The developer of every game that was up for Game of the Year. You know, Bethesda with Fallout 4, Kojima Productions with Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, From Software with Bloodborne, and Nintendo with Super Mario Maker. In a weird way, I actually I kind of wanted to see Kojima Productions pull this win. Just because I wanted to see a developer who no longer exists win Developer of the Year. I think that would have been a really funny, like middle finger to Konami. And you know what? I'll talk about that a little later. Talk about the stuff with Hideo Kojima and all that in a little bit. But next, I think this might be the dumbest thing. And yes, this might be the dumbest thing ever. In a bunch of stuff that had a trailer for a freaking Lego game, we got our first look at Rock Band VR.
Guitar Hero Live.
Okay, Guitar Hero Live, super interesting thing. Really like what they did. I really hated how they kind of came out and said, yeah, Rock Band VR. This is the first time something like this has ever been done. Ooh, I'm like, Guitar Hero Live. Stop, are you shaking your head in agreement to me? Or, okay.
Get with the program.
You talk about Guitar Hero. What, Rock Band? Yeah, that.
It's just Guitar Hero, but you wear a thing on your head and gives you motion sickness. It's Cloverfield the game.
Christ. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. It's like you actually see yourself holding the Rock Band controller, you know, and it shows all the buttons lighting up, and you know, it looks like a Rock Band game just in first person, which is really nauseating because the entire screen's like smoky, and
The short clips they showed were making me sick.
Again, that's another problem that I have with VR, is the fact that I can't do it because I'm going to be throwing up everywhere.
Play through the pain.
Christ. Alright, let's move on here. Best Art Direction! Those nominated were Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, Witcher 3, The Wild Hunt, Ori and the Blind Forest, Bloodborne, and Batman Arkham Knight, which, I will say Batman Arkham Knight in this category. That was an interesting kind of, I don't know. That was an interesting kind of, like,
I'm surprised Life is Strange was in there.
I don't know.
It has an interesting art style.
Yeah. I really like the colors and the way they made The Witcher 3 look. Metal Gear Solid 5 had its own unique style. But obviously the winner in this category had to go to Ori and the Blind Forest. That game is just so pretty. It's just like they just threw colors at a fucking canvas.
In the good way. Not the like Mythbusters explosion painting way.
It's not Bob Ross. But no, super interesting. Congratulations to Ori and the Blind Forest. The game I need to go and play. I don't know.
I want to play it.
The next trailer we saw, we got a nice little look at, I think they're advertising episode 6 of,
Game of Thrones.
episode 6 of Telltale's Game of Thrones. Holy crap!
I
my god. That was quickly followed by a look at Shadow Complex Remastered. Kind of looks like a new, kind of like a 2.5D side-scrolling game. Really interested. Apparently, if you donated to the game, you can get it on Steam. Or no, you can right now download it. What, for free? On.
I don't even remember this.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember. It was something you can download it now on ShadowComplex.com or something like that, and you can find it on Steam this upcoming January. Really interested to see that. You know, it's a really neat remaster. It looks beautiful. And all that, and I believe this was a new Rocket League on Xbox One. Apparently, that's coming out. Just gonna continue to spread
is
the word.
Just for PS4? Or
PS4 and PC, I believe.
Oh.
I didn't know either. I thought it was all. Let's see here. We had the next category was Best Action Adventure Game, and I'm a little sad that Assassin's Creed Syndicate didn't win. Although I will say, because I did all the only one that I really knew was in this category was Assassin's Creed Syndicate, but also in the category was Metal Gear Solid V, The Phantom Pain, Ori and the Blind Forest, Rise of the Tomb Raider, and Batman: Arkham Knight. Now that is some stuff. That is some stiff competition right there.
I didn't realize Ori and the Blind Forest was action adventure.
It's such run. Yeah.
Is that a platformer?
Kind of.
Yes, I need to play this.
Holy shit. Maybe we'll put it on the channel, do some joint commentary and whatnot.
But I should play it.
Maybe.
Like for me playing it. I'm good at things. I beat some of the AC games. I just haven't finished Rogue.
Okay, we'll stop.
Vote for the pretty one.
This is what our days are filled with, everybody. Metal Gear Solid V, The Phantom Pain, won Best Action Adventure Game. Not surprised. As soon as I saw Metal Gear Solid V go up, I'm like, yep, it won.
But I'm disappointed in what it also won.
What, the fact that it also won Best Soundtrack?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll talk about that in a second.
I actually do want to see what else was in that category.
But really, I mean, Rise of the Tomb Raider is super interesting. I still need to play Rise of the Tomb Raider. Batman Arkham Knight, I played that to completion. Really fun game. But I really wanted an Assassin's Creed game to come out with that one. Especially being Syndicate, in my opinion, best Assassin's Creed game. A long time. I think it's about my second favorite in the franchise. No, actually, I think as far as the franchise goes, this is my favorite game, and I don't know, I won't go into this because it's a big kind of rigmarole, but as far as the Assassin's Creed franchise, this has actually been my favorite. Really fun. I don't know, I think there's something really cool there.
Okay.
You know, if you haven't gone out and played it, I'd suggest play this new Assassin's Creed game. Really fun. And this is on, you want to read it?
Yes.
Okay. She's about to read you the nominees for Best Soundtrack.
Fallout 4, Halo 5 Guardians, Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain, Ori and the Blind Forest, and that is a cool picture, and The Witcher 3.
Right there was that's the nominees for Best Soundtrack. Personally, I'm really, nothing against Fallout 4, I just think its soundtrack is a bit forgettable.
I mean, you have to turn it off on all your radios.
Yeah, but no, Witcher 3, I gotta say, I thought was easily the best soundtrack. What do you?
Well, I mean, I know I haven't heard Halo 5's, but Halo has that I assume they didn't just completely blow their chances out of the water and just not put in the theme that everyone knows.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I think that's in there, but it's fighting with The Witcher. The Witcher had such a beautiful soundtrack.
But Metal Gear 1.
Yeah!
Did Metal Gear have an actual score, or was it all soundtrack?
Yes,
there is a difference.
Some score, some soundtrack. But I will say, I think The Witcher was just... The action moments felt good.
If you're fighting against those old school rock tunes, no, you're not gonna win. But if it has an actual score,
there was a lot of old school music. I'm trying to remember when this game was set. Cold War era, I believe. I don't know. I'd still put money on the Witcher. I had my money on Witcher 3. I thought the score for Witcher 3 was so much fun. I thought that was going to be the easy winner. Really interesting to see Metal Gear Solid 5 pull that win. I don't know. Some more kind of interesting stuff kind of came with this. The person to go up and kind of get the receive the award for Metal Gear Solid 5 was not the game's creator and series creator. I don't know why I blanked there. Hideo Kojima, actually Kiefer Sutherland, the man who voiced Snake in Ground Zeroes and Phantom Pain. Kiefer Sutherland was the man to kind of receive the award.
And then he took a shot for it later.
Yeah, and actually that was pretty fun. We'll talk about that in a little bit too. But no, Kiefer Sutherland was the man.
We're almost at an hour.
Yeah, I know. This has been pretty fun. It was the one to kind of come up and receive the award. I'm not with a company. I can say this, and I'm really a dick move by Konami's.
Yeah, especially no,
please
when...
don't sue me. A dick
you're
move on
Konami. You're allowed to express your opinion. That is right.
Yeah, I mean, I they're from Japan. It's different. I'm sorry. God damn it, I'm being racist. I'm sorry. I'll stop now. And a dick move on Konami's part. Apparently, Hideo Kojima was told by a Konami lawyer that he would not be allowed to attend.
Even though he wanted to.
Yeah, to attend the Game Awards.
He was in Tokyo.
Yes. Actually, no, because right now, if you believe Konami, he is on an extended vacation from the company.
They said he was in Tokyo watching it.
I don't know. He's apparently on an...
He doesn't have to go anywhere for a vacation.
He's on an extended vacation, although there was that really funny, really sad going away party that was all over the internet. It was all over the internet. It was that really sad going away party. I don't know.
Was that when they played the song for it?
Yeah, at the award ceremony. Then they also, played one of the songs from Metal Gear Solid 5.
They performed it,
really interesting, kind of, I don't know. Wasn't a huge fan of it, because it's about not the song I would have picked. I don't know,
think if you're going to use a chorus, you should actually be able to hear the chorus over the orchestra,
I don't think it was fair, to not allow Kojima to kind of come up and receive the credit for a franchise that really he's put his entire life into.
Mm-hmm.
It's really sad. Hideo, if you ever somehow hear this, thank you so much for the Metal Gear franchise. Really, I've only played one or two of them. But seriously, for what they are culturally into the game industry, thank you so much. I still love some of the poor translations and some of the earlier ones. The base is filled with English. The truck have started to move. I love Wolf. But seriously though, Hideo, or Kojima-san, whatever, thank you so much for the Metal Gear franchise, and best of luck wherever you go. Please go to Sony. Please go to Sony. Please go to Sony. Please go to Sony. Ubisoft. Or Ubisoft. Go to one of those. I'm gonna get crap for that. Let's move on. Next, we saw a trailer for Star Citizen, a new kind of... I know, RP, yeah, you were on your phone at that point.
Was it?
Yes. It was.
No, I saw it, I just didn't know what it was.
I don't know, I have no idea. Kind of like Mass Effect in a way. Interested to see what's going to come out of that. If you know more about that than I do, go in the comments, find me on Facebook, Twitter, all that. Alright, we're winding down here.
That is the third page.
Yeah, we only have about another three categories to... Yes, three categories covered. Best performance, which is actually handed out by, and why can't I remember her name? One of the leading producers on the original Assassin's Creed game, now actually over working with EA to create.
Who took a shot?
Who is actually now working with kind of like an open world Assassin's Creed kind of like game for EA? Really interested to see. Good luck with that. Really interested to see what's gonna happen with that. But no, she was sitting out there, you know, it's like, because she was giving out, you know, she's naming some, like, these big character names, and kind of looks at, she says, and where would, you know, the voice of Snake be without David Hayter, knowing that Keith Sutherland's out there in the crowd.
And then proceeded with, I'm sorry, that was kind of mean.
Oh, that was awesome, because, yeah, David Hayter. I don't know why they had Kiefer Sutherland play the new Snake. He didn't talk at all. I don't know. but no, also earlier, Mark Hamill kind of came up while he was talking. If you don't know Mark Hamill, he's voiced the Joker in just about every animated Joker for a long time. The only one not, he didn't voice it in Arkham Origins, the Arkham game done by Warner Brother Games, not by Rocksteady. I don't know, fun little fact there for you. But no, I'll read the people nominated, who they played and for what game, and I will just say real quick, Mark Hamill got screwed over on this one. The people who were nominated for this were Ashley Burch, who played Chloe Price on Life is Strange, Doug, I'm gonna guess Cockle. I can't say that name without, like, kind of like some spitty Cockle, who played Geralt of Rivia in The Witcher 3, the entire Witcher franchise, but Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Mark Hamill as the Joker from Arkham Knight. Camilla Luddington?
I'm sorry.
Luddington. Who voiced Lara Croft in Rise of the Tomb Raider and the first one in this, like, new reboot. Really good voice acting job, in my opinion. And who won, to much chagrin of mine, Viva Seifert?
Seifert,
who played Hannah Smith in Her Story. I don't know. I mean, that's a really weird that she won, and this isn't best voice actor, it's best performance, because she was in a live action game, but, I don't know, I mean, this is really weird, you know, and again, with so many good characters, personally, again, you heard it here first from me, Mark Hamill as the Joker should have won, because Mark Hamill's Joker is phenomenal.
I'd say either Chloe or Ashley Burch or Mark Hamill.
I don't know. I honestly don't understand that choice. Nothing against Her Story. I haven't played it, though. But yeah, I have to agree with her. I also threw Doug Cockle in there, too. I really like the performance he did with Geralt. I really like Geralt's character. Maybe I like him more for the writing than I do for the performance. I don't know. Either way, the next last thing that was shown, we got a nice little look at a upcoming 3-episode kind of mini-series by Telltale Games that's going to kind of go into the Walking Dead franchise. We're going to be seeing Walking Dead Michonne. It looks like we're going to get some, because I know the TV show's kind of gone into her backstory. I don't think the comic series has. I'm not super far into the comic series itself.
Have you read any of it?
Yeah, I've actually read
Yeah, that's right. You started
23 chapters. I say chapters. I read manga a lot. 23 I don't know, like, what it is for comic books. Editions. I'm sorry. Editions. What? Yeah, let's go with that.
Maybe?
I don't know. I don't read comics that often. Either way, it looks interesting. I say it looks interesting a lot, but, you know, I don't know. I find a lot of what happens in video games interesting. And finally, the big one. The Game of the Year for 2015 nominees are The Witcher 3, The Wild Hunt, Bloodborne, Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, Fallout 4, and rounding out, Super Mario Maker. Actually, and the developers of that being The Witcher 3 with CD Projekt Red, Bloodborne from Software, Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, Kojima Productions, rest in peace, Fallout 4, Bethesda, and Super Mario Maker by those folks over at Nintendo. Any opinions on that? On any of that list? I thought that was going to be a really tough fight. All around, just because, like, each game kind of has their merits. In a weird way, I thought I was rooting for the underdog in The Witcher 3. I knew it was super big. Got a lot of really good, it was really well critically acclaimed, except it just kind of, like, I hadn't heard anything about it, except for the fact, I thought it did DLC right. It's doing, the expansions are really cool. With only one of them out, and another one coming out soon. I think early 2016.
Is there another one coming up?
Yeah, there's one more. It was Hearts of Stone, and then I want to say Blood and Wine is coming out not too long. I think early 2016. But you know, I thought that was in anything. I thought that was going to be the underdog because Metal Gear Solid 5 was a lot sooner. Everybody's loving Metal Gear Solid 5. Apparently not selling as well, though. I don't know. Fallout 4, I thought Fallout 4 was going to be a lock for this one. You know. Because she's going to cry if I don't put it back. Because Fallout 4, you know, is freaking Fallout. Although really, a lot of people weren't super happy with this one. I don't know why. I really dig it.
I still find it funny that the one playthrough you have, the one episode you have that I'm in, that has...
Two.
Huh?
Two.
I know, but one of them that I was in. Actually, no. Yeah, I'm only in two of Fallout. One that has the house building, has the most views.
No, come back. You're free today, right?
I mean, yeah.
You should do the Vegas.
Suppose. I don't have a cooler to sit on anymore.
We'll figure something out. Either way, you know, I don't know. I thought Fallout 4 was in a good chance. Bloodborne was getting a lot of, you know, a lot of fame, especially with its new DLC and the Game of the Year edition of that game coming out. And I say Game of the Year, you know, it's more like the limited edition, special edition.
Why did they call it Game of the Year edition if they don't win Game of the Year?
There's a Game of the Year edition for,
Batman.
Yeah, Batman. There's a Game of the Year edition for Dragon Age Inquisition, and it didn't win either.
I don't understand that.
It's the game with all the DLC.
I still don't understand that. Call it something else. It's not Game of the Year.
It's another way of saying Definitive Edition or this or that or whatever.
But it's a lie.
Yeah, I agree with you. I don't get that either. But you know, but Bloodborne had that, especially with the old Hunters DLC, and then there's Mario Maker with all of the old guys behind it. Although I will say, I was really rooting for The Witcher 3 and those guys over at CD Projekt Red. Best of luck with whatever they're doing right now.
Witcher 3 is next gen only, right?
Yes.
I'm going to need to borrow your PS4. Eventually.
There you have it, everybody. After about an hour and 7 minutes now.
Longest video ever.
Of talking about this stuff, you know.
This is longer than your regular episodes.
Yeah, I know. Jeez, this is there's just a lot.
I'm not doing a list of events.
There was a lot of stuff to talk about in this one. A lot of fun talking with you guys. Thank you, Heather, for joining us.
You're welcome.
Yeah, okay.
Please keep watching.
Yeah. Everybody, thank you so much if you know you made it through this entire video. And you can deal
congratulations.
Dealing with us. Thank you so much. At any time, you know, if you have any comments of anything I do, or especially in this video, you know, anything that was talked about, please tell me in the comments below. Talk to me on Facebook or Twitter or my website. All of that stuff's in the description below. You know, check all that out. You know, please, if you like this, anything else on the channel, like, comment, subscribe. All of that. You know, check out everything else on my channel. You know, check out my Let's Plays. Check out my weekly show, The 11th Hour, which goes live every Friday at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. Check out this Monday, where I'm going to do my kind of a PSX sort of wrap-up kind of thing. And that about does it, everybody.
That's tomorrow.
Yeah, shit, that is tomorrow. Either way, there you have it, everybody. You know, there's our wrap-up of the Game Awards. Tune in. I'll keep tuning in going into the next year. I have a bunch of projects still leading, still kind of coming out before the year's over. A bunch of projects starting next year because we have a jam-packed schedule. But everybody, thank you so much for tuning in. Tune in to everything else on this channel. I am AJ Gels.
I'm Heather.
This is Heather Scott. I'm AJ Gels. This is Heather Scott. We are the 11th Hour Gaming Channel. Thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in. We're out. Keep gaming yourself. Keep tuning in. See you guys.